everybody, I am Jarrett Ross, the Genie Vlogger, and I am here at the Genie booth in the Expo Hall at RootsTech, and I am here with the General Manager of Genie.com. Can you please introduce yourself?
Hi, my name's Mike Stangel. I've been with Genie since 2006.
Wonderful. So can you tell us a little bit about the history? How did Genie get started, and how has it gone along?
Sure. So when we started Genie, we really wanted the focus to be on family. So one of the first things we did was we developed a family tree interface that nobody had seen before, which was that it didn't just go up to your ancestors. It went wide as well to your nieces and nephews, your cousins, and so forth. So that was a new family tree interface that now you maybe have seen in other places as well, but it was pioneered at Genie. And the other thing that we did at that time was that we knew that maybe you were going to start a tree on Genie, and so was maybe your second cousin, and eventually those trees would run into each other. So we developed a merging interface where if we had overlap between two trees, you could connect those trees together into one larger tree. And that really became the impetus for what is now known as the World Family Tree on Genie. Over the years, what has happened is one of those trees got larger and larger until it got to the point where we had this snowball effect that it would start merging in with every new tree that came into Genie. So we are now at over 130 million profiles, all in a single interconnected family tree, and that connects about 4.5 million users together as well. Now, in order to make sure that this tree is well-maintained, we have over 200 volunteer curators who take stewardship of the historical lines in the tree. So they're not going to tell you that your grandmother's not your grandmother, but if you go on to King Henry and try to add a brother that maybe doesn't already exist there, our curators will catch that and say, hang on, unless you've got a source, we can't really add that to Genie. So we're very grateful for our curators because they do a fantastic job of making sure that the information you find on Genie is accurate, well-sourced, and that duplicates are merged together. So that's how we got to where we're at today.
Wonderful. Now, in 2012, MyHeritage acquired Genie.
Yep.
Can you tell us a bit about that process, how that happened, and what that's meant for Genie.com?
Sure. So that was a really great moment for us in the development of Genie. MyHeritage, as you know, is one of the largest companies in the online genealogy space, and we were very grateful to team up with them when they acquired Genie in 2012. And it's really been great since then. We still operate as an independent website, but one of the things we've been able to do as part of the MyHeritage family is that we can now integrate the Genie World Family Tree with the MyHeritage records collection. So as you add profiles to your Genie family tree, we can match against what MyHeritage has in terms of census records and birth certificates, newspaper clippings, and we can surface those to our Genie users and encourage you to find those matches, confirm those, and bring them back to Genie, which you can then use as source citations as you build your family tree.
Now, I know that there's a new feature that just hit Genie.com. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Yeah, so we're super excited to bring back our GEDCOM importer. As you may know, GEDCOM is a file format that lets you transfer a family tree between software. We initially had a GEDCOM importer in Genie, but we didn't want everybody's Charlemagne because we've already got a really good one. So what we've done is we've rebuilt our GEDCOM importer to import your family tree in stages. So it'll import 5 generations, look for matches, and if we can connect you to Genie's World Family Tree, then terrific, you've already got what you need. And if not, then our importer will continue to import your tree as fully as necessary so that you have your entire family tree on Genie. So, you know, everybody likes to build that line back to Charlemagne and beyond, and that's fantastic. We love the enthusiasm. We're fortunate that our curators have done an outstanding job on our medieval tree, and even more recently. And so, to be honest, your GEDCOM file probably contains only a small portion of what we've already got on Genie. So by implementing our GEDCOM importer the way it is now, you can get the full benefit of what's already on Genie, but also build your family tree without having to enter it all by hand.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now there's one last feature that we were talking about that hasn't actually gone out on Genie. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure, so just to give you a little preview of something we're working on, we have an inconsistency checker that we've been building for Genie. And although you don't know it, it's already been monitoring your tree in the background for things that look like maybe you've got a mistake there. Maybe somebody was born after you documented when their child was born, for example. So that would be something we would want to draw your attention to help you correct errors in your family tree. So we're working on that hard. We've got a little bit more work to do, but expect to have that coming out in the next couple of months.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for talking with me, and hopefully a lot of people will be checking out Genie.com and joining the World Family Tree.
My pleasure. We'll see you on Genie.